end my show with a bang. You know, because they always do that on whatever stand-up comedy or when someone's telling a story. They kind of end the show with a bang to sum everything up of what they were saying. And I haven't done that yet. I tried, but of course, it's never going to happen. Or, you know, it'll never end with a bang. Take that literally, physically, or metaphorically, it won't probably happen to me. I mean, it's simply just because probably just the universe is against me or something. Of course, on this, during my story and my show, I've kind of made myself look kind of pathetic. Just because for a whole bunch of reasons, I don't know. Of course, my story isn't that boring. It just, or my situation doesn't seem that bad, but it only is because it's so many situations or so many problems that it would be too much to sum up, and I just give some different parts of it, but I keep feeling like it's not important, or I'm not telling my full story because I'm leaving out so many parts of it, and I don't have the time to get real detailed, and you also just don't see the real hardness, or you know, the how messed up my life is, or you know what I mean. And probably no one will ever want, I mean, not only do I make myself look pathetic, but also, you know, I'm a virgin, and not too many people go for that. Let me see where that is. Just, let's think about this for a second. If you took, a person, and they were maybe sweet, you know, sensitive, caring, even good looking, funny, smart, whatever, you know, all the qualities. I'm not saying I am those, I'm just saying take someone that has those qualities, and they were a virgin, it would totally change your outlook on them. You would just not them, or you wouldn't see them. It just really dampers anyone's, you know, their kind of full person. Of course, I've kind of gone, or, you know, tried to, most people try to hide it, and I tried to for years, but, you know, it didn't really get me anywhere. So I'm, you know, once I, this last one, I did this, I just decided to admit, you know, I'm a virgin, and, but they just wouldn't look the same, no matter what qualities they had. I'm not saying I have many qualities, or, you know, I'm just kind of, also, I'm kind of crazy, or, you know what I mean, partly my situation, or the situations I've been in, but I'm like, so crazy, it's pathetic sometimes. It's like, I'm so insane, but I don't really care, because I have, that's how I'll always be, you know, I'll always be trying things, and, you know, doing this and that, just because life is too boring if you just settle and become, like, a certain character, or, you know what I mean, not a certain character, but a certain character of society. You gotta be your own thing and not really stay in the boundaries of one of the characters of society, or, you know, what people put, how people put people in boxes, and, you know what I mean, just kind of, you're this person and you act like that just cause people expect that person. I don't know, you know what I'm saying. But then also, people will not like me because I hate my family. You know, most people don't like someone that hates their family. I hate the cops, which some people don't care about that, but most people can care. And I hate YouTube. No one's really gonna care about me hating YouTube. That's not really gonna be a turnoff. But there are two others can. Of course, I'll never get into a relationship, not only because of my past relationships, but also because, not only because of how much I hate being around, being around my family, but also the two, if you can call them relationships, or the two people I like to love that. But it's just, I see disaster from relationships. Because I could get over the problems I've had with the girls I've liked, or the problems I've had with my family, just any of my past problems. But it's always going to be a problem with relationships. It's just, two people, they eventually, they just get too jealous and get too, just they don't trust, and even people that stay together, which a lot of relationships nowadays break up, and I'm not just talking about, like, younger relationships, even people that get married when they're older. And even ones that stay or, don't mess up, they still are miserable most of the time. And not only that, but relationships, you would pretty much give up on your life. And I'm not just talking about having fun or doing something you want to do or that kind of thing. But even if you wanted to help people and just your family is priority, you're not able to have any life pretty much outside of your family. It's just they're what you're supposed to. And I see that, because my sister I guess she's not really in a relationship. I mean, her and her boyfriend have problems. And that goes for both of my elders. And my parents, they have, just everywhere you look. Everyone that's in any kind of relationship is always fighting. And they're so unhappy. That's just how it is. And I've had a lot of fun, though. I'm not trying to make my story look too bad. And as far as girls, I've had, it's like I hang out with a whole, or not anymore, but I used to hang out with a whole bunch of girls, I always ended up messing with them. I think I only used one of the girls as an example, but I think she was kind of the one that was the longest period of time most of the other. But even with her, it didn't go anywhere. I'm just saying, I knew her.